Where are you from?
From Bogota, Colombia.
What was your first break?
My first break was Homeland on Showtime. I was in season 3. I played Esme, and it was lovely. But then back in Colombia, my very, very first break was first a TV series and then a movie called The Art of Losing, which premiered by Sergio Cabrera, Colombian director. And that movie premiered at Venice Film Festival. And that was a dream, definitely.
What have you been in?
I've been in, in Homeland. Before that, I was in Rage, a film produced by Guillermo del Toro, which premiered in Toronto. That was amazing too. And I had a small role in Biutiful, Alejandro Iñárritu's, and The Hidden Face by Andy Weiss. It was a co-production with Fox International. And Narcos, no. Narcos Netflix show.
How do you feel about this career?
It's like, obviously I like being part of something creative, of working with a lot of passionate people and creative people, but there are things that I don't like as much as the actress lifestyle, be waiting for everyone to approve, and what else? You can't really create things on your own. Sometimes you just depend on a whole lot of people, and that's pretty boring sometimes.
How did you decide to become an actor?
Well, I think maybe I have a feeling that with the arts, it's not that you really kind of make a decision. You don't sit down and decide you're going to be an actor or something. I think it's you can't not do it. It's something so you're so passionate about that it becomes vital. You have to do it. So I don't know how. I guess it was. My mom used to take me to classes, to drama classes, to ballet classes when I was a girl, and she would take me to a kid's library that I loved and buy me a lot of books, and I would read them and sort of fantasize that I was the characters I was reading about, and then I sort of wanted to be lots of things in life. And I guess an actor, being an actor, is what pretty much allows you to be different persons.
How would you describe your specialty or type?
My specialty is that, I'm from Colombia, and I can dance, I sing, I write songs, I speak French. I went to a French school since I was a kid. I speak English too, and Spanish, and what else? I'm super healthy. Does that count?
Who is your favorite actor you look up to?
Definitely Isabella Jenny, the French actress. She's always been my muse. She's so inspiring. She's the best, the absolute best actress in the world. Zoe Lund, too. I loved her. On Miss 45, she was just amazing. And did you say actors? Or okay.
What would your ideal job be?
My ideal job would be working with kind, passionate, really smart, creative crew, telling like a great story, and with a great script in a great place. And I don't know, it's like I grew up, like for me, art and movies and books were like life-saving, really very meaningful for me growing up. So if I can make some good works that can help other people grow up, that would be great.
Do you consider yourself to be lucky?
Yeah, definitely. Not that I'm the luckiest person in the planet, but I mean, of course, I'm absolutely lucky. I've had some amazing experiences. I've been to beautiful places, and there's a lot more to come. And I mean, life is so difficult for a lot of people. You know, life can be really scary and terrifying. So of course, like, you know, like just being able to walk is already being lucky. And I have the best family in the world. I have the purest love ever from them, and that's just, you know, I couldn't ask for more.
What advantages do you have?
What advantages? Didn't I answer that already? No. I guess to be, I don't know if that's an advantage or not, but it's a good time for being a woman. Like, I really like what's going on, what's happening now. You know, some sort, not that we're anywhere close to equality, but, you know, it's like now you can pretty much define yourself, and you don't need, like, others to do it.
Would you rather have a car or a diploma?
That's funny. I guess it would be cool to have a diploma from, like, you know, like a proper big huge diploma, not whatever diploma, like from Harvard or the Sorbonne. I should have it, actually. I just, you know, I still have to some exams left. But anyway, it's like, I think that I would love to have a diploma, but it's nice to have a car because you get to go to places and have experiences, and you know, you can always learn through experience. That's pretty much Schopenhauer, not me. But it's like, it's very, you know, your own experience can teach you a lot.
What do you think about the need for instant gratification?
Instant gratification? Does that even exist? I don't know, like, I sort of imagine that that would mean like a coconut, like a vegan coconut ice cream with rose. I don't know if that's what you're asking, but that's some sort of idea that comes to my mind as of instant gratification. I don't believe in that. I think the biggest gratification you can have is when you work a lot on something and you struggle and it looks like it's impossible and you're not going to get there, and then you got it. So that's like, yeah, I don't believe like instant gratification, like just maybe like having a pizza, watching Netflix. But
how do you feel about how interconnected the world is becoming?
Wow. I have sort of mixed feelings about it. You mean like social network and all that, I guess?
Yes.
Because it's kind of tricky, because you... sort of feel that you get to know people from all over the world. But, and I'm not to say that, I don't want to say that's not, that those are not real relationships or like it can go, it can't be on a deep level, but I kind of get the feeling that what's happening is that you can spend way too much time on other people's lives, and much more than your own, and that doesn't make any sense, you know. So I'm not sure. In a way, I like it. It's nice to kind of know what other people are doing on the other side of the world. But I'm not sure if that's totally true. If, it seems to go so fast that it's kind of overwhelming.
What does the future look like to you?
The future? I don't even know what I'm going to do tomorrow. I have lots of things to do. The future seems like a very abstract thing. For me, I try not to think too much about it these days. Get me a little anxious. But I guess, I mean, I hope and I'd like to think that I'm gonna make progress as a person, as a human being, and as an actress too.
How do you feel?
Yeah, I just hope it's gonna be good. I hope. For me, like for the planet.
How do you feel about having children?
Oh my God, those are pretty tough questions. Well, again, it's like I know. I mean, bringing someone to this world, I guess it has to be an amazing experience, and I sort of sometimes don't want to miss out on that. But then I don't want to. I feel like I just can't. I don't want to get too deep or sound too pretentious. But anyway, like death is death, and I just cannot. Stand the idea that if I bring somebody to this world, I'm gonna have to leave him or her alone. It's kind of sad, but I'm, you know, a little tragic.
What challenges do you feel the world is facing today?
If we take the world like as of human beings, I would say like there are same challenges as of all time. I mean, like love, death, religion, peace, war, hate. I guess it's just like the same challenges since the beginning of time. But if it's like for the world as a whole, I would say environment and empathy. I think it's one of the things that I'm amazed that is still missing. You know, like empathy is a huge thing, and it would change kind of the world. So yeah, it would be great if, you know, there would be more empathy in this world.
What are you most grateful for?
I'm grateful for my family, definitely. I absolutely love my parents and my brother and my cat. He's my baby, absolutely. And there's a little cat here. So pretty. I said cat and she just came. Hey. Sorry. Just want to hold her.
What is your favorite?
Yeah, so my family, definitely. And like, yeah, I've had a beautiful life, you know. Yeah, I hope I still have a little time on this earth, but it's been good.
What is your favorite way to communicate?
Communication is like a huge thing. It's not easy for me sometimes, so I guess that's why I'm an actor. It's actually a way to communicate through your work. You are telling things. If I was to say, like for example, I'm better at writing definitely than speaking, and so if somebody's ever waiting for me, still waiting for me to say something that I didn't say, so they should buy the book I'm gonna release sometime soon. I've been writing my whole life because I'm better at writing, but anyway, face to face is good too. I'm not good on the phone at all, yeah, I guess music too. Yeah, I write little songs that say a lot.
What is your favorite book, film, and music right now?
Right now, that changed everything, because you know, like my favorite, just a list came to my mind, but then you said right now, so it's a whole different answer. Right now, my favorite book, well, I don't know if it's my favorite. I love Camus. One of my favorite writers is Albert Camus, and I love The Stranger, and I sort of read it again a month ago. But I also read, I always, I can't read just one book at a time. I always have like three books around, because I kind of feel you don't want to have the same read at the beach than before going to bed. So I have like, I have The Idiot by Dostoevsky. I have a very different one, Not That Kind of Girl by Lena Dunham. And I have, what else do I have? I have Lettres Intimes, which is a French book where you get to read private letters, private correspondence from like amazing people like Napoleon, Chopin, Flaubert, and so it's kind of, you know, it's lovely. And favorite film? My favorite film right now could be, I just watched it on Netflix, it's Pure with Alicia Vikander, who I love. I knew she was going to get the Oscar because I happened to watch that film like a week before the Oscars, and I was like, wow, what an actress, she's amazing. And so yeah, Pure, and then Miss 45, I love it too, like my one of my favorite films ever. And any film with Isabella Gianni, like L'Histoire de l'Alache by Truffaut. And my favorite music. All of The Cure, I just saw them a month ago at the Hollywood Bowl, and I'm completely crazy about them. I love them. I saw them before in London a few years ago, and I just saw them again. So yeah, and I've been listening a lot to Bach too. Yeah, I like to mix classical music with some other stuff.